Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 10 tips for taking screenshots on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. First, let's start by reviewing the keyboard shortcuts you use to take screenshots. If you go into System Preferences and then Keyboard, then go to Shortcuts and then Screenshots, you'll see all of the options here. Now the first four options have been around for a long time and they allow you to use a quick keyboard shortcut to take a specific type of screenshot. For instance, Shift-Command-3 will take a shot of the entire screen and store it as a file. But you can use Shift-Command-5 to do any of these four things plus a whole bunch of more options. So it's a lot easier just to remember Shift-Command-5 and it's what I use most of the time. Unless you're taking a certain type of screenshot all the time, it's just easier to do Shift-Command-5 and have all the options available. So when you use Shift-Command-5, you get an interface at the bottom of the screen that looks like this. The first three options here are screenshot options. These are recording options. So you've got Capture Entire Screen, Capture Selected Window, and Capture Selected Area. Now you can choose any one of these and I will remember it for next time. So let's stick right now with Capture Entire Screen. My first tip is going to be some keyboard shortcuts here for the next step. If you want to exit this, all you need to do is press the Escape key and it closes it. If you want to take the screenshot, then you can go over here and click Capture. You could also click on the screen that you want. I've got multiple screens on my Mac, so I can actually move this camera cursor to whatever screen I want and it will take a screenshot of just that screen. If I use this Capture button here, it's actually going to give me all three screens at three separate files. But I could just use Return to bypass having to use the Capture key. So a quick Shift-Command-5 and then a Return will take the screenshot. Now of course you notice that it first appeared as a thumbnail at the bottom right hand corner and I had to wait quite a long time for it to appear here on my desktop as a file. I know a lot of people complain about this and it's easy to skip. It's just a setting. So let's use Shift-Command-5 to get back into this interface and click Options. It's Show Floating Thumbnail. If you turn that off, now when I hit Return, it immediately saves the file. So we have complete control over how it works. Now there are also other options here. Whether or not you have Show Floating Thumbnail on or off, I'll turn it back on. If you set it to some of these special options, it won't appear as a thumbnail, but go directly to a specific app like Mail or Messages. Let's set it to Mail. And now when I hit Return to capture the screen, it immediately opens up a new email message and you can see the screenshot is there as an attachment. So if sending screenshots in email messages is something you need to do quite often, you may want to set it to this as the default. And note that when you change either the floating thumbnail option or where the screenshot goes, it affects the other keyboard shortcuts as well. So if I use Shift-Command-3, it will actually do the same thing. Here it's putting in an email message, which is what I had it set to. So if you want to use Shift-Command-3, but you don't want to have the floating thumbnail, simply set it to save to wherever you want it to save, and then turn off Show Floating Thumbnail. Now when you use Shift-Command-3, it immediately saves the document, in this case, all three of my screens right here on the desktop. Now let's take a look at some of these other screenshot options. In Capture Selected Area or Portion, you select that, you get this area here that you can move around. You can adjust the sides and the corners to capture exactly what you want. Now sometimes you may want to just capture and you can use Return to do that. Other times you may want to adjust to go to Clipboard. But there's a trick that you can use. You can actually use Command C right here. So I have it set to capture to a file. But if instead of hitting Return or pressing the Capture button, if I just do Command C, it copies to the clipboard. So now if I take a look at what's in the clipboard, you can see I've got that screenshot. And it's ready to easily be pasted into any other app that will accept an image. You could do the same thing with a full screenshot. So if I switch to Capture Entire Screen, I can do Command C and it captures the entire screen to the clipboard for me to paste in anywhere else. And that works with the Capture Selected Window option as well. Now speaking of cropping, if you'd rather crop after you do a capture, you can easily do that by using the option Preview here. That will send the screenshot directly to the Preview app. So in this case, let's capture the entire screen. And you can see it's going to open up Preview and open up the capture inside of Preview. Now that I'm in here, I could easily select any area I want and then use Crop or Command K to quickly crop to that area. Now it's in preview here. I can use Command S or File Save and save it wherever I want. And you could also select and then Command C to copy an area. So now I could paste it into an email or a message or another app. Now another way to do this is to actually use that floating thumbnail. This is what makes it useful. So if I have the floating thumbnail turned on and I capture the screen, if I click on the thumbnail there, now I can go in here, use this cropping tool and crop it. It works a little different than it does in preview. It looks a lot more like it does in photos. And crop the area, hit done, and it will save just the cropped portion. So there are a few ways to crop a screenshot after you take it. And note that the floating thumbnail does have a lot of useful tools in here. Not only can you crop, but you can do just about anything you can do in preview, including annotate it with drawings, shapes, text. You can even sign things if it's a document. And then you could send it to various different places right from here without actually having to save the file. And if it's something you don't want, if the screenshot isn't of use to you after looking at it, you can click the trash button here and it goes away. There's never a file for you to have to delete. So now let's take a look at capturing a window. When you have this selected and then you click on a window, it will capture the window and put it in a file. Now if we look at that with Quick Look, we can see there's a lot of extra space around it. That's including a shadow behind the window. If you don't want that shadow, you can turn that off, but you have to do it in Terminal. So in Terminal, we're going to use this command, which is defaults right, which will change settings. And the settings we want to change are com.apple.screencapture. The setting itself is disable-shadow, and we're going to set it to true, disable those shadows. Then we want to use kill all system UI server. That restarts the system user interface server, which is what controls screenshots and displaying windows and things on the screen. So we'll use that. Now, when we go to do the same thing, we'll capture the window again, and we're going to get a screenshot. And you can see here that it's got less of an area around it because it's not capturing the shadow. To turn it off, all we need to do is use false instead of true. And I can use a semicolon here to separate the second command. So I can do this all on one line. One simple paste of this command here and then return, and it sets disable shadow to false. Now here's another preference you can change using the terminal. Instead of disable-shadow, we're simply going to change type. And here you can put three characters that represent the type of image that gets saved. By default, it's a PNG, which is lossless. Every pixel is perfect in the screenshot. But those files can be a little large. If you want to compress it a little bit, you can instead use JPG for JPEG. And now it will save screenshots as a JPEG image. So when I capture now, I'll get a JPEG image here. I previously captured the exact same thing using a PNG. And if I look at information for the PNG, I could see that it's 5.2 megs. And for the JPEG, it's only 442K. So considerably smaller. It's going to still do a pretty high resolution JPEG, but it will be somewhat compressed. So it won't look as crisp and clean as the PNG. Now other values you can use here are GIF if you want a GIF file and PDF if you want a PDF. That's going to actually create a JPEG and put it into a PDF document. But it could be useful if you need to take a screenshot and send it to somebody as a PDF. That's how they want it for some reason. Then you can save your screenshots directly to a PDF like this. To set it back to the default, just change this to PNG. And now it will return to using PNGs as the image type. So a few more tips here. One is if you want the location for your screenshots to be somewhere besides desktop and documents, you can choose other location. So for instance, let's go into the Finder here. And let's say in my Documents folder, I want to create a new folder and I'll call it Screenshots. And then I could go in here, choose other location. In Documents, I can select the Screenshots folder and choose it. And now it'll save all of my screenshots here until I change it again. This is much better than cluttering up your desktop all the time. And it's pretty easy to change. So if you're working on a project where you want to save all the screenshots for today in a certain folder, you could set it to that. And then tomorrow you could change it to another location to save your screenshots. It's not permanent. You can change it all the time if you want. Also note that if you take a screenshot and you have the floating thumbnail option turned on, when you capture, you can actually take this thumbnail and drag it to a folder right away and we'll place it in there. Now a question I sometimes get is, what if you want to capture something like, say, a menu here? If you bring up a menu and want to include that in your screenshot, as soon as I hit Shift Command 5 and then I go over here to capture, it's going to remove this menu. But you can use the shortcut Return and you can see it actually captures the menu. Another way to do it that can capture even trickier things is to use the timer. So if I go here to Options and set a 5-second timer and then capture, it's going to count down. That gives me an opportunity to select some things in the menus and it will capture exactly what happens when the 5 seconds or 10 seconds elapses. And I've got one last tip for you. You can actually capture the screen of the touch bar on your MacBook Pro. You can't use Shift Command 5 for that. It doesn't appear as an option. But if you're using a MacBook Pro with a touch bar and you go to Keyboard Shortcuts and System Preferences, you see there are two options that Macs without touch bars don't get. And that's to capture the touch bar either to a file or to the clipboard. This will obey various settings like exactly where you want the screenshot saved and all of that. But you have to use Shift Command 6 or Control Shift Command 6 in order to capture the touch bar. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.